Welcome to my world, everyone. This is Like It or Not with Michael Lane, and Michael Lane is who I be. Be sure to check me out on my politics page. That's youtube.com/likeitornotpolitics1. youtube.com/likeitornotpolitics1. All right? That's how we do it. That's some real street tea party conservative talk. So go over there, you know, hey, if you agree or disagree, go there, holler. Hey, open up dialogue. That's what it's about. And now let me open this up. My man, y'all know Bill O'Reilly. Oh, I'm sorry. Bill O'Rhino. Yeah, Bill O'Reilly. Your man, you know, Bill O'Rhino is at it again. Let me tell you something. There is a new threat to society. And you all know how musicians are the threat to society. You know, rappers, different people like that. And now it's R&B people. They are threats. And one of the biggest threats and one of the biggest, most horrible influence of all time is Beyoncé. Yeah, Beyoncé is a threat. I want you parents out there, never, ever, 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 ever listen to Beyoncé in front of these kids, because she is a horrible human being and a horrendous influence. That's according to Mr. Bill O'Rhino. Now, Bill O'Rhino has been on his show and he's been talking about this video. I don't know the name of it. I don't follow Beyoncé like that, but I like some of her songs, you know, a couple songs here and there, you know what I'm saying? But you know, he was talking about this latest video. I don't know the name of the song or anything like that. And she was talking about the lyrics and, oh, this is bad. Then he started bringing up statistics. Over 70% of black women have babies outside of wedlock. So, that's what Beyoncé did. She made that song. She made that video. And she told kids, she told women out there who's not married to screw. He's got the problem down pat. This is what Bill O'Rhino is about. We got to thank Bill O'Rhino. Thank you, buddy. You know the answer. You have the answer. You got it down. All we got to do is talk to Beyoncé and other R&B singers who are a horrible threat to society, because we all know how bad. See, black people, yes, there is a problem. But the problem can be eradicated. There is a problem. 70%, over 70, that's ridiculous. But Bill O'Rhino, leave it to my man to just put this finger on the pulse of the problem. And the problem is, just like in the 70s, look at these bad, horrible influences like the Isley Brothers, Teddy Pendergrass, I can go on, Earth, Wind, and Fire, a Tower of Power, Brass Construction, the Stylistics. I can go on and on with these bad influences. They were horrible. And that's why we have so many are born outside of wedlock. Wedlock, look, not only just Beyoncé, you know. Let's not just talk about Beyoncé. We could even talk about Aretha, because Aretha did some bad things too. You can't make no slow song. Prince? Oh, no. Adore? Do not let kids hear that. That's the problem. We need to just eradicate the music. Stop love songs. Get it out of there. Stop having racy lyrics. Get it out of there. Because only black people get influenced and listen to music and do crazy things because of music. Only black people. Yo, boy, I tell you, Bill O'Rhino got it all. And I tell you, Beyoncé is such a damn threat. He gave it to Valerie Jarrett. He said, why don't you tell Valerie Jarrett to come over here? Why don't you tell Valerie Jarrett to get Michelle Obama and tell me, and have Michelle Obama say, y'all don't do that. That'll stop, and that'll change everything. Bill O'Rhino is one of the biggest phonies in the world. And I'm going to tell you why he's a phony. He's a fraud, okay? A lot of people say, well, some people, you know, somebody told me that I saw that video you did on Bill O'Rhino and talking about, you know, you were defending hip-hop. But Bill O'Reilly got a point, man. And plus, you know what I'm saying? He's got a point. But check it. No. He don't have a point. He keeps talking about unsupervised children. And they can listen to it and get influenced. Who leaves their children unsupervised? Parents. Parents are the problem. We have media who is uplifting, who continues to uplift artists, which is nothing wrong with uplifting musical artists and stuff like that. But when you don't uplift those who achieved academically, we also have a problem. Then the kids don't have anything to look up to or look forward to. We're in a sad state when we rely on artists, music artists, to actually raise our kids. I have two children, and I'd be damned if I'm going to let my kids be influenced or raised by an athlete, by a rap star, a rock star, or other stars. Because the bottom line is, no matter what you say or do, the kids usually repeat what the parents do. That's the biggest movie they see. They don't care about what movie they see on the screen. They don't care about what movies. If they want to be a rapper, they want to get away from what's at home. They're looking at the TV and say, ooh, I wish I can be that. Because it sure as hell is hell here at home. If girls continue to pop up pregnant, that's because they usually sometimes see their mama with a man every other week and popping up and getting it on. That's the influence. But Bill O'Reilly is a phony, because if you really want diversity in hip hop, if you really want to change the music or change something like that, if he has such a bad problem with rap and want to get rid of rap, and want to get rid of R&B and all that stuff. If he really has a problem, he knows what he can do. He knows this. He can go to the top. You know, like Fox, 20th Century Fox, Columbia, Sony. He can go to CBS. He can go to DreamWorks. He can go to Geffen. He can go to the... These guys do that. These guys program what you listen to. I'm talking about the big industry. Okay? There are artists out there, man, I'm telling you, that they could put out all kinds of great stuff. These big wigs will send it back and say, no, do it that way. But Bill O'Reilly knows this. He knows this. Some people say, well, he attacked, it's not just about blacks. He attacked Eminem. He attacked Marilyn Manson. He went out. No. He touched them. Madonna, he brushed on them a little bit. But he's on these guys every day, whether they're rappers or R&B singers, just as long as they're black. And he just concentrates on them, and he pounds them. But he's just like your everyday rhino. He doesn't get to the source. He knows he's not going to get to the source. You know why? Because what he wants to do is destroy the artist. He wants to destroy people like Ludacris. He wants to destroy 50 Cent. He wants to destroy Snoop Dogg. He wants to destroy Nas. Tell me, would anybody other than Bill O'Reilly sit back and say Nas is a horrible influence rapper? Really? We're talking about Nas. This is the same dope that turned around and called Kanye West a gangster rapper. I kid you not. A gangster rapper. Kanye. Bill O'Reilly is everything music, ain't it? I'll go to him for my musical knowledge. All things music, Bill O'Reilly. He has his destruction gun. And he wants to destroy artists. That's why he did what he did against Ludacris. He spoke out against Ludacris being in a Pepsi commercial. He wanted to destroy Ludacris, not the record company that's telling people what type of music to make. Bill O'Reilly is not a dummy. He knows what he's doing. He's full of crap. Beyonce is not the problem. Ludacris is not the problem. The BLACK is not the problem. You know who's the problem? It's Bill O'Reilly. Because he's just like these race baiters. He's just like these race pimps. It's not the fact that he's out of touch. Bill O'Reilly knows what time it is. He just don't want you to know what time it is. Like it or not.